Hey everybody, welcome back to This Old Trike. We have a lot of things that have happened in the past week, I guess. Not even that, but as always, it takes a little bit to get things put together for you so you can see what we've been working on. We got the third 350X from the barn find that we got all tidied up. Number four is looking really good too. And the one we just finished up, would you believe it? It hopped in the back of a stranger's truck. Well, he was a stranger, but now he's a friend. So come on, let me show you what we did. Today we've got to start off with something very important. There comes a time in every person's shop life where he realizes that his shop has gotten too messy for his own good. I spend more time looking for stuff than I do working on stuff. So, we've got some updates to do to this machine. This machine just needs an air filter and a new seat cover and the headlight bulbs put in. Air filter was shipped to me incorrectly, so that's taking a minute, but Palin is cleaning our stash of spare fenders now. So, when you got three sets of fenders laying around, they take up room. So what we're going to do is we're going to get this on the new wheels, and that will allow us to move things out of the way over to this area. I've got some wood here for a project that I need to do that I need my table saw for. My table saw is acting like a table. All my surfaces have stuff on them. It is just atrocious. My 250R project has become a table for things. This is just ridiculous. So let's get this cleaned up. What do you think, Tango? Should we get this shop cleaned up? Yeah, I think you think so. So Palin, how have we done today?
Good.
Good. Let's show them what we did. So we put the new rims and tires, which I don't know what machine they came off of. It could have been this machine. But we had a front max sitting on the shelf, and we had some tusks, something or others, sitting on the shelf. So I had those mounted up. I put the snorkel and the airbox tube to the carburetor back on. We had to take the whole fork out. I feel like on a 250R, I've been able to get the front tire off without removing the fork, but I had to do it this time. And at this point, all that's left to do on this machine is put the decals on the tank. I've got a grab bar from ATC waiting to be installed, so that'll be going on here shortly. But it's amazing what just some fresh aluminum rims will do to the look of a machine versus these things that came off it. Just atrocious. But with decals on the tank and the tank scoops, this will be a running, riding, great machine for somebody. Just like that one over there. Wouldn't you agree, Palin? All right. Let's set the phone down and do something else. So some parts have come in for this little beauty. New seat cover, air filter, headlights are in the house. They're not in the shop yet. This one we did some work on yesterday. Me and my partner got the front fender on it. The wheels and tires. We've got tank decals to go on this. We have this grab bar. Let me brag on my good buddy Craig Burton from ATC. Reach out to him for all your aluminum grab bar needs. He has the standard ultra lightweight grab bar, also has the nice desert grip wide grab bar for pretty much every model that you need, everything even down to a 70. So we're putting uni filters on these. You can see this grab bar definitely needed to be replaced. This one is the lesser of the two. It's going to have these faded Myers on it. If somebody wants to put new Myers on it and make it look like $1 million, they can. The seat will need to be recovered, but the foam has some issues. But I got my partner with me here today. What do you say, Palin?
I say something.
Say something. There you go.
I don't know.
We cleaned up the shop a little bit. We're ahead as far as where we were yesterday, but not where we need to be. So getting these out and down the road to a new home will help us free up some space for more projects. Thank you. Okay, time for a little update. You probably saw us install the uni filters in the time lapse. We also installed the Addicted to Detail ATC grab bar on the back and got rid of this one. All wonked out, poor thing. We put the tank decals on. I put a new fuel line on this machine, so I am pretty much done with this. I got to put new headlight bulbs in it, except I need to put the seat cover on, and I'm going to talk to you about that in a second. I did notice my petcock leaking a little bit, so I don't know if the inner seals will expand and seal up now that it's been exposed to gas. It's off in the off position. It doesn't leak, but I might have to swap that out at this point, which is a little frustrating. Got some lenses for this guy. I need to change these bars out because I notice they will make contact with the tank in this area. And just moving it around the shop, I've noticed that. So they're not going to work on that machine. But this machine, outside of some headlights, is done. I'm going to put the headlights in. And they're used lenses. They're not perfect, but this machine isn't perfect. I got to put the master cylinder on. But when I swap the bars out, that will all happen. So this is pretty much done. This is pretty much done, except I took the seat cover off. And I wanted to inspect the foam underneath. And the foam is savable, but this, I had a number of sheared off bolts that were not okay. I had another seat that's got a big old gash right across the middle. But the seat pan was good, which I have sitting over there on the stove to dry out. Don't want to let it get too hot. Yeah. So this has all the right bolts. The underside is nice and dry. I'll vacuum off my work area. I'll glue this seat down. And I'm going to talk you through the process of how I put a seat cover on. I've never had to go down to the pan, but my daughter is detailing these, the underside of these fenders. You're doing great, honey. That's my GoPro. Has a mind of its own today.
What is going on?
What is going on? Well, let's stop and see if we can find out. Okay, so here's what you're going to need to do a seat cover. Well, some of the things. You're going to need some of this spray adhesive. And that's what we normally use on top of the foam to hold this down so it doesn't span that angle. You want your seat cover to stick to the foam. But since we've had to remove the foam, we're going to use it also to stick this down. You can see they glued it back here. We're going to glue it up here as well. But I'm going to spray a little adhesive on this area because this is your forward mounting brackets. You can see they're taped down from the factory, so we're going to pull that off. And we are just going to spray a little bit of that contact adhesive in there to hold those in place while we stick the foam down. Let me find a place to put the camera. All right, so I've got my spray adhesive here. I'm just going to make sure this whole thing is dry because I did just wash it. All right. So this can has done about probably five seats over a couple years. It's contact. So I'll spray both surfaces. I sprayed the threads. I'll probably regret that later, but we'll run with it now. So I'm going to give that time to get tacky. Once I do that, I'll again just kind of sweep out some of the dried pieces of old foam before I spray the adhesive down to stick down the new foam. That needs a little bit more time. We'll come back here in just a second. Okay, so that's gotten tacky. So that is just gonna hold that in place, because once the foam is on it, it's not gonna be able to go anywhere. And since they're two locked together, that should keep it stationary. I am just gonna use this paper towel to wipe down little pieces of foam that are stuck on this. Okay. I don't want to put new adhesive over old adhesive that isn't going to stick anymore. Okay. Now we'll take our adhesive. I'm not going to do it over this towel because I don't want that to get sticky. That should be good enough. Again, once the seat cover is on, it's all going to be sandwiched together. The other part we'll have to do is on the seat foam in the opposing areas. All right, now we just have to let that set a minute so each side gets tacky, then we'll put them together. Okay, we're tacky again. So I'm just gonna set this down into its home. And it pretty much grips right away. If you've ever used contact cement or anything like that, it's the same idea. So we've got our studs, four at the back, two in the middle, four at the front. They're held in place by the foam now. So now what we're going to need to get is a pneumatic, I suppose you could use an electric also staple gun, but a regular staple gun is not going to cut it. You're not going to be able to get the staples through the seat pan. The seat cover I bought is not a seamless seat cover. I opted to get the one that has seams, just mainly for the fact that the letters on the side will, that allows them to be straighter. It is really hard to not have an arch in the letters, the pre-printed letters on a seamless seat cover. And I've done probably half a dozen seat covers, and I can get them pretty good, but I try to be a perfectionist, so it bothers me when they're not perfect. So here is the seat cover I opted for. So it's got a seam at the back, and it's got this seam here. It's still going to take a fair amount of work to get it to look good. Without the seams, you have to stretch them more. Some people will put these in their dryer to soften them up. I mean, this is room temperature. It's been over by my fireplace, so it's going to be fine, and it's going to be plenty easy to stretch. What I'm going to do at this point is spray the adhesive on the top, and I'm going to focus it in this area because you do not want your seat cover to span that area. And you can draw it in and tighten it, but that's going to help it to stay stuck down there. And I'm not going to get it on the sides. I don't want or need it on the sides, but it'll just help things stay put. Need to spray this on the seat cover as well. While that's setting up, I opted to get some 5/16 staples, and I'll be using them in my cheapo Harbor Freight staple gun. These are what I was using last time. I don't remember what I was using last time. Let's see if I got the same thing. Quarter inch just seemed a little too short. You don't want them too long to blow through the back side of the seat cover. Yeah, I was using 5/16 before, so that's right on. You just need something with a little oomph to blast the staple through the seat pan, because that seat pan can be hard. With a seamless seat cover, and for the most part, it's the same idea. You want to make sure your Honda is centered on the back. I'm going to start at the back and roll the seat cover forward into the adhesive, because I can adjust, I can pull material over the front, but that Honda needs to be where it ends up. And it's got to start where it's going to end up, and it has to be centered. So that adhesive is getting close. So what I'm going to do, maybe I need to change my angle so you can see more what I'm doing. We'll do that. So that should work pretty good. I'm going to get the seat cover.
I'm realizing at this point that other times that I've done this, I've actually lined up the back before I sprayed the adhesive. So the fact that I've got the adhesive on there is a problem that I'm going to have to work through.
Just going by feel at first here.
Other times before I've sprayed the adhesive down, I've actually positioned it and stapled at the rear, ensuring that the Honda wording is centered and in place before I spray the adhesive. So I actually start with a few staples in but I'm already past that point, so we're gonna play it as it lies from here.
They've got a seam right here that I'm gonna use to center this with the seam on the seat pan. So that's just going to pin it so I can pull this tight.
So everything is fine here. It's just that I had to lift up the seat cover up off the adhesive, and he could have done that beforehand before he sprayed anything.
Everything else will flow from there. At this point, it's just the name of the game is folding this over and drawing it tight, especially with the letters are. You want to make sure you're not pulling one area more than another. With a seamless seat cover, the corners are a challenge because you'll end up with material here. You're trying to keep the letters flat. It can just be a lot of extra work and stress. I'm all about trying to reduce stress in my life. It's nice to be pretty underneath, but it's not the end of the world because this is all going to be sandwiched between your seat and your fenders. You can end up with a lot of little wrinkles up here. I just keep rolling it over, holding it in place while I can get a staple in. So you see there's a lot of material left over here, so I'm going to tuck that and roll that in. I don't have a background in any of this, so I'm just kind of self-taught and do what has worked for me in the past. It's kind of like wrapping a birthday present. I'll take a razor blade at the end of this and cut around these circles. I've never had a seat cover. I haven't had to do that too. All right, so at the back, I've got this extra here that we need to do something about. I've never had a seat that I've not had to pull a staple out of to tighten things up. So, just being honest. So I'm taking out the ones in the corner here. I don't want to mess with any that get too close to where it says Honda on the back. I don't want to make Honda into an arch. What I use to pull the staples is a pick like that. You can get under and pry, and then just a pair of wire snips to pull them out. I think I'm going to pull everything on this side and really tighten it up, because I want that cover to be nice and tight. Okay. So I'm really going to pull and roll this under. Kind of compress the foam. Helps you get slack out of things. Looks good. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side, and then I'm gonna pull all the staples at the back and draw that down as well. I think that's the safest way to do it. If you do upholstery for a living, and I'm making you cringe right now, I apologize. Okay. Home stretch. Okay, I'm going to call that done. I'm also going to criticize myself. I don't like the extra material here. I don't know if just my seat foam had kind of rounded over, so it's not as pointy as it used to be. But there's a little bit of extra material there. I don't think it's the fault of the seat cover. If I was a better upholsterer, I could have done it better, but I'm pleased with how that looks. I've got no puckers. There's a seam there or a crease from where it was folded. I can still feel some of the imperfections that were in the foam, but they don't jump out. The underside looks decent. I'm going to cut those circles out before I put it on the fenders, but we're pretty much done. Let's see how it looks on the machine.
All the brackets are installed. All the studs were good. Adhesive didn't mess with those at all. So
Now I really want to see what it looks like on the machine. Got a tag of some sort, I didn't notice. This is tricky to do one-handed. Well, I do say that is a huge improvement. I just got to get those light bulbs put in it and verify that the petcock isn't going to give me trouble. I think I might be being optimistic with that. Well, I barely got it finished, and the new owner couldn't help himself and wanted to treat himself to an early Christmas present. So Lucas is going to bring this lovely 350X home. Nick, you don't got to move. I was trying to want to get you in. Look at this. I think it's prettier on the screen.
Oh, absolutely.
And Nick couldn't help himself, so he bought a motor. That's a nice 84 200S motor of unknown provenance. Palin is still cleaning. But we're going to pause this so Lucas can get this thing wrapped up and loaded up and sent home. Soldier. And as we discuss the plans for this, seat cover, headlight lenses, fork boots, gotta swap out those bars, get the controls all finished up on it, but it's essentially pretty much there. Seat cover, you know, takes a little bit, as you've just learned in this video, but the friend of the new owner of the 350X that we just sold is very interested, so we might have a buyer for this guy lined up. So that's exciting. As always, thank you so much for watching. I enjoy it. I know my daughter enjoys, you know, working on things, and it's motivating to have kind of people to be accountable to. You know, I put myself out there, you see what I'm working on. And I want to deliver week to week. So thank you again. Make sure you like and subscribe. You don't want to miss out on any of my updates. Going forward, we have a number of projects. We got our 88 Big Red to work on. We've got a couple of smaller, less sexy projects. We've got this 250R right here, the one I've owned since 1997, that needs the motor refreshed. It's all on that table over there, so I'd love to have that table back. So that's coming too. Those are probably the two bigger ones, the 88 Big Red and the 250R. So stay tuned for those. Again, like and subscribe so you don't miss out. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you very soon.